Okay guys, I have to be honest, I'm quite stoked about this one. A lot of tuners will not like it, but I think it's always very important to be honest to the viewers. So, let's just recap. You want more power, more torque, but most important, you want to save fuel as well. Let's give a quick tip. It's not going to happen. Hello and welcome again to a new episode of our tech series. Today's topic, chiptuning versus fuel economy. Well, it's a controversial topic. Almost every day I get the question, will my fuel consumption drop after tuning my car? Well, the answer is quite simple. In most cases, no. Yeah, but they all claim that you got 5 to 10% lower fuel consumption. Okay, yeah, they may do. But have you watched our latest video about the truth of chiptuning? If not, I'll put a link somewhere here. Explained in short, if you want more power, you need to burn more fuel. So how could you still make more power with lower fuel consumption? Yeah, but my car is tuned and my onboard computer is showing me a lower fuel consumption than before. Aha, there you got it. Your onboard computer shows you a lower consumption. But have you done the effort on recalculating your consumption manually? I guess you don't. Okay, let's explain how this all works. It goes all back into the days tuning boxes were very popular and chiptuning wasn't done that frequently. What happened with the tuning box was it's a device that plugs between the existing sensors of your engine. In case of a diesel, mainly the fuel pressure sensor and in some cases the boost pressure sensor as well. How this works is the tuning box misleads the engine computer by letting it think that the fuel pressure and boost pressure are lower than they actually are. Of course, the engine computer is monitoring all of its sensors and notices this. And it takes its measures to solve this pressure difference. But the amount of fuel injected is dependent on the fuel pressure and the time the injectors are opened. So, because of the engine control unit is full and the fuel pressure is higher than it thinks, but still, the injection time has remained, you are injecting more fuel, thus delivering more power. If a lead is back to fuel consumption, what happened is, for the same amount of power, you'll need to apply less throttle. Because, due to the power box, you're injecting more fuel by the same amount of throttle. This results in the engine control unit thinking it's injecting less fuel, hence lower fuel consumption. But, in fact, you're injecting the same amount of fuel for the same amount of power as before you installed the tuning box. Okay, this seems quite logical, but how does this work with chiptuning? Well, what a lot of tuners tend to do is, they create the same tuning box effect in their tuning strategy. When tuning a car, there are altered different maps inside the engine control unit. One of those maps is the injection duration table. This specific table tells the engine control unit how long the injector should be activated to inject a certain amount of fuel by a given pressure. So what they tend to do is, they take this table and they add a percentage gain to the used area of the map. What this does is, the computer is opening the injectors longer, so injecting more fuel without even knowing it. Because it just listens to what the table tells it to do. This results into the same effect as a tuning box, which explains why your onboard computer calculated consumption is lower. If you look into this table, you see the values in red are changed, but you do see the axes are not changed, so they just altered the values by a percentage, which you can see in the lower table. If we take this into consideration and we do some quick math, this means that if your fuel consumption was 8.5 liters on 100 km before and you subtract 5% of this, your fuel consumption drops to around 8 liters on 100 km, on your onboard computer at least. It's quite logic. What would you expect, that a single individual would succeed to lower the consumption drastically while dozens of engine engineers in development have been calibrating everything to get as low as possible emissions and consumption? It's just not realistic. Okay, in some cases you will have a bit lower fuel consumption. See it like this. For example, before the tuning, you may need 18 seconds to go from 50 to 120 km an hour. Because of the power increase, you'll need significantly less time to go from that same 50 to 100 km an hour. This results in a shorter time of applying throttle, which can in some cases result in lower fuel consumption. But don't expect miracles of this. Besides this, the more power you have, the more you will use. Okay, so I hope we cleared up some things in this episode. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching and see you next time.